Hello and welcome back for another edition of the Multicultural AFL Football Show. Tonight we review round number 2 and also preview round number 3. I am Vanessa Gatica and I'm joined by my two co-panelists, Javier Sincan and Gabriel D'Angelo. Hello guys.
Hello Vanessa.
Hello Vanessa. Hello Javier.
Hello Gabriel.
Round number 2 got underway last Thursday night at the MCG with Collingwood tearing the fabric out of Richmond by 44 points. Friday night saw Adelaide dismantle the Swans at the SCG. Sunday's night last quarter capitulation by Houghton in letting the Bulldogs kick 9-1 for the quarter to win a 5-goal come from behind victory. Javier, that would make you happy, isn't it?
Yes, I'm still happy, and I believe that was one of the great comebacks by Bulldogs, and to come back from a deficit and then score like 9 goals against Hawks, that's just pretty amazing. Put aside what's the controversies about the free kicks, so as per Alistair Clarkson said, it was just happened in the momentum, and they would be rowing. There's no point in rowing for those problems, what happened, those free kicks. But overall, they just let Bulldogs take over the game, and that's where they were mainly falter. And with the other games, Adelaide, I don't know what's going on with Swans at the moment. And Adelaide were meant to lose that one at home ground. Sydney Swans should have won that. But I think this year, either they're following the trend they had the last year, or I'm not sure, because even last year they were not good at their home ground. So they're just falling on the trends at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, you're right. There was really no excuse for Sydney to lose that one, you know. But just coming back on what you said about Hawthorn versus the Bulldogs, I mean, you're exactly right what you mentioned about Alistair Clarkson. He did say, yes, even though that free kick shouldn't have been a free kick, it was a really bad, really terrible decision. They should be embarrassed for doing that, because that was not a free kick. But having said that, Alistair Clarkson did say Hawthorn, there was no excuses, they should have won that game. They were in front for the majority of the match. They were actually quite comfortable in the final quarter. In fact, I was watching the game and I thought, well, Hawthorn can't lose from here. And
yes,
then I found
exactly
out afterwards, oh wait, Bulldogs actually won. How did this happen? But yeah, I mean, there was really no excuse for Hawthorn to let that one slip, even though that free kick shouldn't have happened and the Bulldogs got in front. And also, there was no excuse for Sydney to lose that one.
Yeah.
I have to say, you know, Adelaide, they were brilliant, because I did not think they were going to stand a chance against Sydney. So congratulations to Adelaide. That was really good. That was the sort of game, that was the sort of win that they really needed.
Yeah, definitely. And Richmond, I believe, they're again proving that this is not their year. They're getting too many injuries, too much fines happening as well. Like last couple of years, they've been avoiding all the fines, all other issues regarding the MRI, and all other issues regarding the players. Dustin Martin, he can't even lay a tackle now. It's getting quite embarrassing the way Richmond are playing at the moment. The way the tackles are being laid by Collingwood on the other side, like they were far more than what Richmond did. Mm. So it's getting to a point where because of those injuries and because of other stuff, I don't know what's happening with Richmond, but they are sort of embarrassing themselves. I would say the 44 point deficit, that's a bit too much.
But if you compare last year, I think Collingwood beat Richmond by about 39 points. So if you want to sort of compare the pair, so to speak, from the last games, there's not that big a difference. So what does that say about where Richmond are going and where Collingwood is going? And what you mentioned about Dustin Martin, I think a lot of other teams are studying Richmond better, and they realise, well, if we stop Dustin Martin and he's not unbreakable, because once he puts his hand on, you know, they just stop him and that's it. He can't do anything else from there. Once they stop him, and also Rance is out for the rest of the season. So that's one key piece of the puzzle in the defensive area. So Richmond are beatable, you know. So, yeah, well done for Collingwood for
that
point.
And I'm not taking anything away from Collingwood. Digoi, he was just brilliant on that night. And others like Adam Treloar, Scott Penderby, they've got a team full of superstars at the moment.
Yeah.
So this team's going to be very hard to beat this year. I believe Geelong were lucky to beat this team in MCG. That was a huge result for me. But I believe Collingwood will be a very strong team this year, and they will prove.
I've got a good midfield.
Exactly.
Very good midfield.
We'll be back with more after this short break. Other games, boys, that impressed me were the Saints over the Bombers, West Coast Eagles over the GWS Giants, the Gold Coast beating Fremantle, and Melbourne's defeat at the close of the Cats. What are your thoughts, Gabriel?
Well, I know I'm going to be a little bit off script, but I actually think that the game between Brisbane and North Melbourne, I was really impressed with that. I really enjoyed the way that Brisbane Lions played. They were excellent. I mean, when you consider how they were for the past 2 years, they were 20-odd points behind in the first quarter against North Melbourne. They didn't falter, they didn't panic, they didn't go into a hissy fit or anything. They just kept clawing back. They kept chipping away at North Melbourne, and eventually when they went past them, there was no way North Melbourne were going to stop them. So I think Brisbane Lions, they're improving so much. I was really, really enamoured with the way they played. I was just so impressed. I thought they were excellent. Their young guys are really starting to gain that experience and really starting to gel together as a unit. Their big forward, the big O, Oscar, he was sensational. I thought he was brilliant. I really do enjoy the way that Brisbane are playing right now. And I don't want Brisbane to fall into the habit that some teams do, where they have this amazing start to the season and then halfway through they start to lose and they start to falter and they start to go down. I hope that bit by bit Brisbane keep getting better, because I really do believe that they're one of the best teams at the moment. That was sensational.
Yeah, really? I believe Chris Fagan shared your thoughts as well, because he said that, don't talk to me finals yet. Mm-hmm. I just want to concentrate on each week. Each week is a different game, so that they just want to build a team. And to their credit, I believe it was something like 2010. That's when they were like they won two games together at the start. And since then, they haven't done anything. Mm. And this is a big moment for them. And the way they are, as you said, the way they're gelling together, that's just fantastic. And on the other hand, if we watch that Essendon Saints game, it was a shocker the way Essendon played. I can't believe. There was nothing what you can say as of AFL standard. Mm. There were a few mistakes. I mean, what more I can say? Their own fans, their own home crowd will wing them. So they are coming up with slogans that this is how our team should be playing. Yeah. So all the spectators had the hoodings up. So I mean, that sort of sums up everything. So I believe there's definitely something wrong with Essendon at the moment. They need to fix that, and they need to do it as fast as they could.
Very briefly, will Melbourne and Essendon bounce back? And are the Saints and Dogs a real deal? What do you think, guys?
Well, I believe Dogs, to me, I believe they're sort of finding their mojo. Because the teams they've beaten, they were both in the top eight last year. So they, if we compare that to Saints and the teams they've beaten, they were not there. And plus the way Essendon played, I believe any other team would have won too, and that came pretty close. That's again, then it's my view. Saints really need to be tested yet. Mm. They haven't proved that, but as we discussed before, Bulldogs have shown that they've got something on in them. That's they've got some sort of rhythm going on between themselves. Where Josh Sake, they are actually kicking goals this time. last year it was like they were going into the 50s and they were wasteful. Yeah. But this year they're actually kicking goals, so that's a huge plus. So I would say that's that probably makes them real deal.
Well, I think it's a bit early to say if a team is the real deal or not. I think but you know, we are only in round two. But you're right in the sense that both teams, well, both the Bulldogs and St Kilda, they were very similar last year in the sense that they would waste so many opportunities and so many chances, and that opposition, media, everyone was expecting so much more from them than what they delivered. Last season was a huge disappointment for both sides. And of course, the way Essendon are going now, it's sort of like they're continuing down that slope, whereas the Bulldogs and St Kilda, they're slowly going upwards. I mean, that's good. There's nothing wrong with that, especially being a St Kilda supporter, you know. But there's still a long way to go, and there's still, you know, a busy season ahead of us. So we don't know who's the real deal yet. Anything can happen. you know, who knows, Brisbane Lions might be, you know, the real, yeah, you never know. So we'll wait and see, but time will tell.
Yeah, and with regards to your other thing, that who will bounce back, I believe Melbourne will bounce back as compared to Essendon.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because looks like at the moment, Essendon's got a culture wrong, whereas it is just that Melbourne haven't been able to find what they had last year. So if they are able to get themselves together, the way there were a lot of positives in the last game against Cats as well. So they need to focus on those positives, the way Oliver played. They still have the players, although losing Stephen May would be a big factor for them as well. But I believe they've got a more chance of bouncing back as compared to Essendon.
Yeah.
Coming up, round number 3 and the grand final replay from the MCG on Saturday night. So don't get anywhere, and we will be back after the break with more on the Multicultural AFL Football Show. So stick around. Welcome back to the second part of the show as we contemplate it. We didn't have to wait long as for the MCG, Collingwood and the West Coast Eagles go head-to-head in the grand final replay. Last year, the Eagles behind all day took the premiership from Collingwood in the final 2 minutes of the grand final. Are we going to see a repeat, boys, or have the Magpies improved? What do you think, Javier?
I believe Magpies have definitely improved. The way they played against Richmond, I believe they, even last year, it wasn't that they were at too much fault, or they didn't play a big bad brand of footy or anything like that. It was just that they lost their momentum, they lost their rhythm for some time, and then that's when Eagles pounced over. So, and having said that, Eagles still got all the team, and still they got probably falling on the same form. I think they were a bit complacent against Brisbane Lions, and Brisbane Lions are better this year as well, so all these factors combined for their loss. But I believe they are the team, a very strong team this year as well. And it's going to be a cracker of a game, I believe. But I've got just a feeling that at the moment, with all that hunger and with all that probably the revenge in mind, Magpies will be a touch better than West Coast Eagles this time.
Yeah. Like with the grand final victory, I'm not too sure if Collingwood lost it or if West Coast just wanted it that little bit more. I mean, you have to give West Coast all the respect in the world because they were 30-odd points down in the grand final at the MCG in front of a lot of Collingwood supporters. There would have been a lot of pressure on them to bounce back, and they did. And they did so very, very well under very tight circumstances in the last 5 minutes. So I think West Coast still has that hunger in them to keep going, to keep pushing. I think you're right in the sense that they were a little bit complacent against Brisbane, that they probably weren't expecting Brisbane to be so good. But I think Collingwood, you know, they were excellent against Richmond. There's no denying it. But because the way they beat them and by how much compared to last year, it wasn't that big of a scale. It meant that both teams hadn't really changed that much. Mm. So having said that, I think that West Coast can beat Collingwood again at the MCG. By how much I don't know, but I think that West Coast can definitely do it.
Yeah, and I believe the battle will be fought in the aerial area mainly. So that's where West Coast can probably really give a good hammering to Collingwood.
Yeah.
Apart from the Eagles and Magpies blockbuster on Saturday night, there are 4 other big games next weekend, commencing tonight with the Adelaide hosting the Cats at Adelaide Oval. Essendon take on Melbourne at the G on Friday night. Saturday's clash between the GWS Giants at home with Richmond Tigers, and the Brisbane Lions at the GABA play Port Adelaide. Who will prevail in these games, boys?
Well, I'm going to start off with the Melbourne-Essendon game because that one's really intriguing. I really do believe that because both teams have been playing so, so badly. Everyone's been expecting much, much more from both teams, probably a bit more so with Melbourne because of that amazing season they had last season. But, you know, Melbourne, last week when they played against Geelong, they were just so disappointing. The season before, they almost beat Geelong in Geelong twice. They narrowly lost both games. This time, last week, they got absolutely smashed. Geelong just gave them a clinic. They should have done much, much better. Well, we all know Geelong were going to win that game, but they should have at least made it a little bit more competitive. Whereas Essendon, well, we all know you know, Essendon are having their problems. A lot of stuff is not going right for them on and off the field. Yeah. It's not a good time to be an Essendon supporter. But in this case, I think that Melbourne would win. And another loss to Essendon, it could put a lot of pressure under John Worsfold. I think a lot of question marks will be raised about, you know, where the direction of the club is going, even though we're at the early stages of the season. A lot of question marks will be all over John Worsfold if they lose that one. And, you know, I want to mention, again, Brisbane Lions. I think they're playing sensationally, and I think that they'll beat Port Adelaide quite comfortably. I think, you know, Brisbane at the moment, they're playing so, so well. They're playing really, really good footy. The young guys are playing so well. They're gelling together. Chris Fagan's got a good game plan going. I think that they're just so, so good at the moment. I think you can tell I'm excited about the way they're going. But, yeah, they're just playing so, so well. And Richmond against GWS, well, at home, GWS should win that game.
Yeah. Look, I'll probably start the same way. Essendon and Melbourne, they both need to lift their game up. I don't care which team loses, but there should be a match like where we can see the competitiveness from both the teams. That's what they need. The last game Essendon played, the 350th game for the coach, and what they come up with, that was shocking. So hopefully they can come up with a better plan with some hunger in this game too. But I believe Melbourne's going to be too strong. And as you mentioned, there were high hopes of Melbourne. I believe Essendon had high hopes too, with Dylan Shield coming in, Devon Smith already there, Tip and Woody playing good, their number one McGrath as well. So they've got all the ammunition. I'm not sure why aren't they firing? And that's they look like they were like a top four contenders. And these two teams, as you said, just shocked us all. So they really need to lift their game up, but I believe Melbourne should win this one. Yeah. And with the other games, I would say I've been tipping Brisbane Lions in every game anyway, so I'm gonna go easy on them. That's it. It's gonna be Brisbane Lions, and yeah. And with the Richmond Tigers, I believe too many injuries. They have to have too many things go right for them, only then they will be able to win. And I believe GWS, after their defeat from West Coast, I believe they'll be too strong for them. So it's going to be a big margin game. This is what I feel.
Yeah.
And I'm really looking forward to that Geelong and Adelaide. It's very hard for me to tip which one would be in that.
Well, yes, but I think Geelong should win that way. I think they're improving.
For me, Geelong.
Yeah, yeah. I think they're going to have a really good season. I think they're going.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that battle between Dangerfield and Rory Salone. Rory Salone, he played very good against Sydney Swans, and so did Dangerfield. So it's going to be a really good battle, whether it's forward or back. And Dalhouse and Gary Rowan, they're sort of getting into that team quite nicely. Mm. Although I think there's some doubt over whether Gary Rowan would be playing this game or not. But I believe it's still going to be a very good match to watch. Geelong should win the way they're playing at the moment. But I believe this is the game which Adelaide will give it to their fans and win that one.
Certainly, an interesting round coming up. Sunday's games might provide a few surprises. Briefly, boys, Western Bulldogs at Marvel against Gold Coast. And don't forget the Saturday game, the Swans with Carlton as well.
Well, I believe Carlton will give them a fight.
Yeah.
The bad part is Charlie Conroe. I believe he's injured. He might not be playing. And I'm very impressed with Carlton at the moment, the way they're playing. If they had the same Doherty as well playing for them, I believe things might have been different. They would have had that extra edge this year as well. But having said that, I think it's going to be a very good game at Marvel Stadium. Generally, Carlton plays good too. But Sydney, I think they might be following the trend they had last year,
yeah,
where they play good away games and bad at home. So I'm going to tip Sydney for this one.
I see what you're saying in regards to Sydney. They've got a really good track record away rather than at home. That does put them in good stead to win this one. But I think Carlton might surprise everyone with a win here. They were very, very good against Port Adelaide in Adelaide.
Yep.
They almost won that game. They've improved a lot. And I think they win this game, then they've well and truly arrived. So I think Carlton are going to win. I hope they win because they've been doing really well. Because they've been doing really, really well.
And I believe the other game is Bulldogs and Gold Coast Suns. There is no reason why Bulldogs shouldn't win this one. Yeah. I believe it should be easy win for them and the way they played against the Hawks. But Gold Coast Suns is like a surprise package this year because they've beaten Fremantle. Fremantle is still
home.
Yeah, exactly. So that's a big factor for them. It doesn't matter what the margin was, but to get a win. Yeah. And at the moment, the Coleman medal letter is someone from Gold Coast Suns, which is probably surprising for a lot of people.
I don't think he knows either.
Yeah, no, I think news would have gone to him by now. Yeah, he's topping the Coleman medal letter at the moment. And Gold Coast Suns, like they, from what we were all fearing, that even the club existence is in a bit of spot of bother at the moment. Yeah. But they've come out good, and they're proving that they are not just there to be like written off. So I believe they're going to put up a good fight. It's going to be a good match, but I believe Bulldog should win this one.
Yeah, no, you're right in the sense that Gold Coast last week, they had a come from behind victory against Fremantle at home, and they should have beaten St Kilda at Marvel Stadium the week before. So Gold Coast, you know, who knows what can happen. Yep. Maybe they're not so easy to beat anymore. We don't know. But I think the Bulldogs, after their performance against Hawthorn, you know, they should, you know, take care of Gold Coast.
So
for me, me, it'll be the Bulldogs.
Hawthorn against North Melbourne at the MCG. What would the Hawks be thinking after last week?
Exactly what we think when you ask us a question. it's respond. Mm-hmm. Yeah. A question have been asked to them by Bulldogs at the moment. Have they got in them? Because it was like a. This was like a question with what the Bulldog has asked them, that okay, we can beat you in your home ground in MCG. That was a big win. So how they respond, that's going to be a very crucial factor. They've got everything. They've got all the ammunition to fire, and I believe they will come out hungry and they will prevail. However, North Melbourne is going to put up a good fight. I think they are finding their rhythm with the new players. Jared Pollock scored a pretty good goal, and I believe if they are able to gel together as a good team, I think they might surprise Hawks again. But I believe Hawks should win just for the tipping purposes.
Yeah, no, yeah, totally agree. Both teams should have been embarrassed for the performance they put in last week. Both teams really should have won both games.
Yeah.
This is going to be an interesting one because I think you're right, Hawthorn will respond a little bit more sharply than what North Melbourne will. North Melbourne North Melbourne are a decent team, but they don't have that sort of cattle that Hawthorn or even Geelong, Collingwood, these sorts of teams have. They don't have that sort of, that talent to sort of make them into a really decent top six, top four team. So I think that Hawthorn are going to win this one comfortably.
The last game of the round comes from Perth, where Frio take on the informed Saints. I will let our resident Saints supporter open with his comments. Gabriel.
Look, the season so far has been so weird. Yes, possibly St Kilda can beat Fremantle in Perth. I think I'm just as shocked as any that St Kilda are doing so well at the moment. But to put it in perspective, they beat Gold Coast at home, which they could have lost, and they beat Essendon technically at home because it's the same ground anyway. So really, Essendon aren't doing so good as any other team at the moment. They're probably the worst at the moment. So there were probably two given games, really, for St Kilda. But Fremantle in Perth, it's a whole different prospect. And Fremantle are improving. Even though they lost last week, I know they'll be disappointed because that was a game that they should have won. Fremantle at home, they're going to be very, very strong. So I think that they're going to win. But this season's been so weird, has been so strange so far that St Kilda could even win. And they might even win by 100 points. You never know. So
well, that can happen.
That is. Stranger things have happened so far. So you never know. But my head says Fremantle. My heart says possibly St Kilda.
Yeah, it's that kind of a match, I believe. Hopefully they've learned their lesson, Fremantle, and they don't repeat their mistakes, what they've done against Gold Coast Suns. And St Kilda, unless they're real deal, I don't think they will win this one. So it's Fremantle for me.
It is certainly an interesting round coming up, but that's all we have time for this week. In the meantime, you have been with the Multicultural AFL Football Show all around Australia on the Community Radio Network and on Aurora-Foxtel. We are also online through the NENBC's AFL Footy website. Stay tuned next week for more Multicultural AFL Football News. I am Vanessa Gatica.
I'm Harvey Singh.
I'm Gabriel D'Angelo.
Thank you for watching.